Hey guys, how you doing? Happy Monday, Big John with J Custom Builds. So I pretty much have Wolf and Sapphire pretty much done. I mean, minus a couple of things, you know, like changing the light bulbs and the lenses to LEDs and then connecting the, I forget what they're called. I think they're little modules or something that so that they won't hyper flash. And so I've never done those before. I just usually get the, I think it's the, not the magic strobe. It might be the mat now. Forget what it is, but usually if I put LEDs on a bike, like even on a Sapphire, I ended up getting that module so they wouldn't hyper flash when I put the LEDs on there. So other than that, man, if you guys are new to my channel, I started building Harleys last year. I built these two, Sapphire and Wolf, for my current giveaway. And if you guys are interested in winning either of these bikes, they're right here, man. $100 entry, $150 for two hats or a hat and a shirt. I have 144 left. As soon as we get rid of those 144, man, we can give one of these bikes away. I also ordered t-shirts, V-neck t-shirts for women. I ordered three different colors. That's not gonna make anything go up. It's still gonna be 144, regardless if we have hats or t-shirts left. But I ordered three different colors, and there's like a teal, a pink, and not a pink, it's kind of like a raspberry color. It's kind of like a burgundy pinkish color, kind of like the color of this shirt right here. And then I ordered a teal and charcoal, like a charcoal gray, a lighter charcoal gray, I believe. And so those will be available like mid-month. I'll be posting those probably around the 15th or the 16th of that weekend, the weekend of. So anyways, I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm going to do a little bit of work. I'm going to take the gas tank off on Blue, drain the tank, and then try to take that gas tank off. So other than that, man, I hope you guys are having a good day. And, you know, let me get started on this tank. I'm gonna siphon the gas out of the bike so that I can take the tank off. Let's see if this works. I don't know how much is in it. Oh shit. I guess that worked, guys. It shot out of the gas tank and shot on the floor and on my leg. See what we got here. Get an extension. I'm taking the two front bolts. There's one back here that I took off, and then there's two on the sides. clean those. And then there's a Phillips right here. This hose comes here. You know what? I'm just gonna leave this right there. Right, and then I gotta take this off. But let's see if I can lift this up and get a little bit more gas out of it. Yep. I'm gonna have to plug that one off. What I just did on that one is I just put a bolt inside of that hose. I don't know if I have another hose that's that size. So I'm gonna put this back on. Take this baby off. Take this off. And stand this baby up somewhere. Okay. Now I'm going to lift this baby off. There we go. Come on. Okay. All right, so I got the tank off, right, guys? And these are the two guys that are shredded that you can see are here, here. Got a little pinched here because it gets tight. It gets pretty tight in here. Here's the blue wire that I soldered. And you can see, you know, that's just the normal wiring for the bike, and it's a lot. That's a lot of wiring. So let me get this back on the stand, and then I'll, all right. So, hey guys, you know, I've been doing this YouTube now for, you know, I don't know how long, but I kind of feel like you guys are kind of losing interest, not only in my giveaway, but you're losing interest in my videos, you know, and that's, you know, that's not your guys' fault. You know, that's my fault. And so I don't want to lose you guys. I don't want to lose my audience, and I want to keep you guys interested in my giveaways. You know, I've been doing my best, man, and I'm not sure what else I need to do to get people interested or get people motivated, you know. Here's the wires. I need to replace these and, you know, get this cover back on here and go from there. So, okay, so I got that out. You know what I'm gonna do now? I don't know if any of you guys have ever changed a clutch cable before, but there's a little pin under here, but you have to first loosen it up down there. So that's what I'm actually gonna do, because you guys can see that I ran this in front in front of the bottom of the triple tree when it goes back here and up. This is one of the first clutch cables that I did almost 5 years ago. And so I didn't record or, you know, try to route it. I don't like how it goes on the outside here. It's actually supposed to come up through here, around here, and then up there. I hope you guys got that. Instead of being on the outside, it's supposed to be on the inside of the frame and then come up through here and then go up in here, not on that side. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take that off right now. So let's get this down so you guys can actually see me loosen that bolt down there, and then we'll go back up. Well, let me get this gas out of here. We don't need this anymore. We need to cut this first. And that's one of the reasons why I ended up bottoming out. I ended up bottoming them out right here. I don't know if you guys can see that. I'll show you guys that later. I ended up bottoming out because I hit a really, really big pothole. And it literally slammed my whole front wheel in the top of this. And then this slammed in the top of the crash bars. And that's what happened. So I think these both right here are 1/2 inches. Let me grab some 1/2 inch wrenches. You know what I'm gonna do, guys? I forgot about my light. Let me get my light so that you guys can actually see what's going on here. You know what I think I'm going to, I think, guys, I'm going to change the front forks on blue as well. All right, so we're gonna loosen these guys up here. Get this one here. Yep, there we go. Oh, wait a minute. There we go. So what I'm doing is I'm taking all the tension off so I can reroute this cable. It is not routed the right way. Let's see if the tension's off. Yeah, but there still needs more. So, yeah. The what? Oh, the side gate? Yeah, hold on. Hold on, guys. I gotta open up the gate for my wife. Coming. Hope he catches them and bites them in the rear. All right. So now I need my. Oh, did you? Is it chewed up? Is it all chewed up? Oh, that little guy, man. Yeah, he's a little shithead, man. So, I think I'm gonna show you guys the pin. You see the pin down there? It's right here. It's not a pin, it's a C-clamp. And I can't see where the little holes are. I'm gonna try to get in there. Oh man, I need to go on the other side and try it.
He did much better with this harness.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. There was, you know that guy that has the little Frenchie down the street?
Yeah.
That dog was there and walked past. Then I got him to like kind of like chase him a little bit. He was afraid of him.
He's afraid of that other dog?
Yeah, that dog wanted to get aggressive.
That other dog is aggressive?
Yeah.
All right, let me see here. So I'm going to have to go in here.
This one's only aggressive with cats and birds.
You know what? I don't even know if I'm doing this right because I can't see. Let's see. There we go. These holes seem pretty small. I don't even know if this is going to go in there. I think I'm just really tired. I went and got a bunch of wood today, guys, for our fence. I was in Home Depot for hours trying to find the best 5-footers for the fence. All right, this might work a little bit better for me, guys. I don't know, hope you guys can see. It might not be the one that I'm used to using, because the one that I use, I kind of ground down the little tips so they'll actually lock in and grab. And I don't think these are it because these aren't grabbing at all. Okay, got it. You see that? All right. So leave this here. Push that pin out. Lift it up. I'm gonna take this. Clutch might have to. There we go. There we go. Pull that out. And there we go. Hang on to both of these. I'm gonna take this. Reroute it through here. Take it back down through here. I'll show you guys what I'm doing, guys. All right. So I got this back out. Now I'm gonna have to figure out how to do it because I have to get it back down underneath the bike and then run it back up inside of the frame. All right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull this. Yeah, it was already getting really chewed up and damaged. So we're gonna go through here now, guys. Come out here. Oh. Gotta get it back in here. Keep it clear of everything. Okay. There we go. Where's the adjustment at? Dang. Wow, this thing is long. So then we're gonna go through here. Then go back. See what we're doing. Yeah, well, that's good. Okay. Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like the way it's pulling on stuff. So we're gonna have to back through here. Okay, there we go. Yeah, there we go. Okay. But I'm gonna have to go through here now, and I don't know how that's gonna. Might be a little too much. No? So here's the cable. It's kind of long, but nah, it's good. So I locked the steering wheel again by accident. Yep, there we go. I'll just leave that in there. Yeah, you know, the steering wheel feels better too. But I don't know if I like the way that is right there. It should come up. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Yeah, that's much better. That is much better. So, you know, I really don't like the way this comes here, but it's not bothering anything. It doesn't look too bad. I mean, it's gonna have to be there regardless, so. All right, guys. So I got the clutch cable ran on the inside now, and it's going up the right way, and then it's coming up right here. So, right there. So, you know, I'll go get those wires tomorrow, get those wires run, get the clutch back in there, get it all adjusted. You know, man, I got the forks for this. They've been sitting for about 3 years now, 2.5, 3 years. The polish, the actual chrome forks, just like the ones that we just put on Woof a few months ago. And, you know, it would look so much nicer with the chrome forks. It would make it look a little bit better, a little bit cleaner. Then it's going to need new tires here pretty soon. You know, it's all apart now. I really wanted to ride it this year. So I might just leave it like that and just do all that stuff in the you know, when the winter comes. But thing about it is, I have it all apart now. Do I really want to go through taking off the outer fairing, and then I got to take the inner fairing off to take those out? It's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. And so since it's all apart right now, I'm going to figure it out. Think about it and figure out what I'm going to do. But I'll let you guys know on the next one. But anyways, I want to say thank you for my audience, all my subscribers, all my customers. Thank you guys so much for watching my channel. And I hope that you guys are still enjoying my content. I'm going to start trying to do a little different content, maybe get some rides on Wolf and Sapphire for the rest of the summer. Maybe I'll just leave Blue down and just focus on riding these two bikes and really trying to get this giveaway done. So if you have not entered my giveaway, my hats right now, they're $100 for any hat and t-shirt, or if you want two hats or a hat and t-shirt or two t-shirts, whatever you want, it's two for $150. And so if you guys are cool with that, please let me know. There's 144 hats left, and I'm really, really hoping and praying, man, that we can get more customers and get more sales so that we can get one of these bikes given away, man. I just want to give one of these bikes away so bad to the winner, whoever the winner is. So I wish you guys all the best of luck, man. God bless. Always remember to ride safe. Take care. Hope you're having a good Monday. Have a great week. In Jesus' name, take care. Amen.